dictated to start a sequence. Sports presents the Big Ticket Winter Edition, the biggest high school sports show in the region. All systems engaged. Stand by. 4, 3, 2, 1. Big Ticket Winter Edition, brought to you by Coordinated Health.
All right, we have some visitors tonight, as you might imagine. They are over in the tweeters tonight. We welcome in the Southern Lehigh boys in our tweeter section tonight, hanging out with Gina. Gina is manning the Twitter handle tonight, as she does each and every night. We would love for you to hit us up at 69SportsBT.
They've been active already.
Yeah, they're ready. They're paying attention. They're enjoying themselves. These are our Twitter handles, and I'm already getting tweets about the beard.
Already?
Which I think is partly because of you.
And take some responsibility.
Ravon Burton, remember our buddy Ravon?
Oh,
he welcomed me to the bearding club.
He likes the beard?
Yeah, he welcomes me to the club. I appreciate that.
Here, Ravon.
Those are our Twitter handles. Hit us up throughout the show. We'll be getting back to as many of those as we can. I just responded to Matt Marcus from ESPN Radio.
Okay.
He's
is he on board too?
Yeah, he's on board.
All right.
He's on board. He likes that you got on the air. He likes it.
So we'll get back to him.
That's exactly right. All right, when we come back, there was a full slate of basketball in the Colonial League tonight, including those young men over there in the tweeters. So you guys want to see your highlights? Yeah, they want to see their highlights. Right. We've got the Spartans coming up and a huge girls game at Notre Dame.
Yes.
Ready for this?
Big time.
Upset City. We'll be back in a moment. So we start with the boys, though, in the Colonial League, and some young men in our studio, and a group from Palisades that I think surprised some people early on. We knew they'd be better. They've been pretty good this year.
Palisades, on the boys' side, hasn't been a factor in the postseason in quite a while, especially in the league side of play, but so far, so good. A narrow loss to Notre Dame, I think that's it. That's their only loss heading into this game, but of course, Southern Lehigh hasn't lost in the Colonial League. So, what would happen tonight?
It goes that way a lot for Southern Lehigh.
It does. Center Valley we go. Pretty good crowd and a pretty interesting game. There's Ben Tanis. He's done a terrific job since coming to Center Valley. And early on, speaking of doing a terrific job, Noah Kandt. This guy was on fire.
He's got to change the name, though. It's Noah Kandt.
Yeah, that's right. Noah Kandt. Knocks down the three from the wing, and he wasn't done. Later on, from the corner, how about a game high? 28 points for Noah Kandt. 14 came in that first quarter. Still in the first quarter, more from Southern. Lucas Hudson comes up with the steal, going the other way. Look at the pass here. No look. The Jacob Castle puts it in. Part of a 17-0 first quarter run by Southern Lehigh. They were in complete control. Palisades finally stops that run here. Final seconds of the first quarter. Landon Mueller, the long three, goes down. So that snaps the 17-0 run. 24-10, Southern Lehigh up by a couple of touchdowns after one. Look at the passing here. Hudson, beautiful look to Logan.
Got a lot of good pass.
Absolutely.
Like that.
Beautifully done. The lead ballooned to 23 in the second quarter. So they're sitting pretty. Bob Schaefer and his staff did such a great job, and they enjoyed that first half. But third quarter, here come the Pirates. Jordan Odell drives and scores along the baseline. He had a team-high 12, brought the lead down to 11. Still in the third, around the perimeter. It's Austin Krause from the top of the key. He drains the three, part of a 12-2 run. Palisades cuts the 23-point deficit down to 5 heading into the fourth quarter. But in the fourth, the Spartans stop the bleeding. Off the inbounds pass, Jack Zamicelli, bucket in the foul. He's been a nice boost inside to the Spartans. And then more good ball movement here. Zamicelli along the baseline. Look at the look to Logan Cuck. Drops the three from the corner. They like it in the tweeters. What a year they've had so far. Southern Lehigh wins again. 67-48. The Spartans go out on top. An impressive win, an incredibly impressive first half. They started to kind of tighten the grips in the third quarter, and then they extend it and get the 19-point win down the stretch.
Hey, you got to like that, and I know they did, and that's why the Southern Lehigh Spartans are in the tweeters tonight. Head coach Ben Tanis is over there, surrounded by his guys. Congratulations on a big win, coach, and I guess, first of all, we talked to you early in the year, and you talked about your basketball team. Did you think you'd get to this point playing this kind of basketball?
I thought that we'd be pretty good, but I wasn't sure that we'd get such a good start into the Colonial League, because the Colonial League's really deep, and I didn't think that we'd jump out to just such a good start.
We've seen a lot of resiliency from your kids. I was at your game a few weeks ago when you were down double digits at Wilson, come back and beat them on a buzzer beater, And then tonight, you see a 23-point lead almost disappear. And in the fourth quarter, you outscore them 19-5 to put the game away.
Well, we talked in the beginning of the year about wearing down teams, and we don't have necessarily the most talented group in the Colonial League. But if we have the attitude that we can wear down every team that we play, I think collectively as a team, with our togetherness, that we can beat anybody in the league.
Seems like they're enjoying themselves, too, not only tonight, but they seem to be a group that has a good time out there. They share the basketball. Those are important things when you have a basketball team that's trying to win games in a league like the Colonial League.
Yeah, this is a great group to be around. They're very close on and off the court, and at times it shows it on the court. They really like to share the ball, make the extra pass, and make the unselfish play, which makes us a better team.
You've got some other heavyweights that are actually rivals. Salisbury's unbeaten in the league. Saucon Valley has one loss. What do you guys have to do down the stretch to keep it going and stay on top?
I think we just need to play more consistent basketball. We have good quarters here, and then we have not-so-great quarters like the third quarter that we had tonight. But if we play more consistently, we can battle with those teams. And I know these guys get up for those rivalry games like Salisbury and Saucon Valley.
You know, it's funny because over the years, we've seen the Colonial League get better and better and better. And it seems like this is a league that's as deep now as it's ever been, with so many teams that could probably win a league title.
Yeah, I think at any given night, any team can beat anybody. And that speaks to the depth of the league. And I spoke about that earlier in the year, that every single team can challenge to win this league this year.
How many more weeks until my beard looks like your beard? That's the other question. How many more weeks do I have here? What do you think?
I got a few. What do you think, Ben? Good look?
Yeah, it's not bad. You can get a little bit fuller there.
I'll work on that. One more quick one for you, Ben. Has anyone ever told you look like Justin Verlander? Have you heard that before?
I have actually gotten that a lot.
Yeah?
I wish I could throw like he did.
Yeah, we all wish we could throw like that. Congratulations, guys. Big win for you tonight. And they stay undefeated in the Colonial League. We appreciate the Spartans being here in the Tweeters tonight. And we'll you'll see more from them a little later on, I think.
Nice.
You'll see something, I have a feeling, a little later on getting the job at Southern Lehigh, both boys and girls. All right, so that's how things went in the Colonial League tonight. The Berks County slate, a little light too, but there were some big basketball games.
Very big games, yeah.
We'll find out who won those in just a moment, and District 1 coming up, as well as the hardware later on. Triple Hots and Ticket Takers, stay with us. We'll be back on the Big Ticket in a moment. Don't forget about the Tweeters. They're over there. They're ready. The Southern Lehigh Spartans busy tweeting away. I've seen pictures. Is Gina making you guys behave? She's feisty. She's tough. We took our selfies with Troy. We're ready to
That's
go.
That's right. Scruffies with Troy.
Yeah, it's changing.
I like it.
Pretty
yeah.
soon we're going to have a beard contest. I'm winning, by the way.
You do?
Yeah. I'll lose next week.
I will catch you. I know. I'll open that door. I had the Italian jeans going on.
We'll be right back on the week. Look forward to covering that all year as well. Don't forget about the Tweeters.
Oh, boy.
Southern Lehigh
proud,
hanging
sir.
Around. Uh-oh.
Is that a first?
It's
We're not liable.
We'll be back. Ready? Time to hand out some hardware on opening night.
First
we'll
time.
Give the Spartans a vote from the Tweeters over there. We'll be right back. Ticket Takers and Triple Hots in a moment. My last minute instructions are in, so we're
ready. Right.
Time to hand out the hardware on opening night of the Big Ticket Winter Edition. We'll start with Dan on the Ticket Takers tonight.
Yeah, I know it was a Wilson loss, but Christian Soto had a very nice game for the Bulldogs. Guys, 19 points in the lineup. Let's not forget that lost Trayvon Code. Jalen Callaway is going to have to be big this year. So at least a good step in the right direction. We'll see if that can get them a couple wins here down the stretch.
We're going to miss Trayvon Code in the opens of the show.
Yes. Anyway.
All right. Well,
we got the Spartans in the house. I'm going with the Spartans for my Ticket Taker of the night. Noah Kandt, 28 points. 28 points, 20 in the first half, and really steamrolling Palisades, especially early on.
Yeah,
miss. Noah Kandt, that's your line, right?
Yeah, Noah Kandt. That's right. That's exactly right. I'm going to the ladies and Gabby Altmaier from Notre Dame. Not only did the Crusaders get a very big win over Salisbury tonight, but she had 24 points, a career high in the process. So Gabby Altmaier gets my Ticket Taker on the girls' side tonight from Notre Dame.
Tonight, they get a vote?
I see a few twos in there.
Yeah, a few.
There are some
twos. There's a lot of threes.
All right.
Fear the beard, gentlemen. Fear the beard. See a lot of threes? We'll give them a three vote.
Yeah.
I'm down for that.
I think two. I don't know. This is a split decision.
We'll have to recount the votes.
That's right.
We'll have to recount the votes.
Let's just see this.
He's cheating. WFMZ.com/big ticket. You can vote all weekend Monday. Find out what the Triple Hop Play of the Week winner is. For Dan Moscartola and Jim Vaughn, I'm Troy Hine. Have a great day.